Welcome to 365 Christian Men, where every day we aim to inspire and encourage with real life stories about men. July 27th, Francois Coillat. Francois Coillat was a missionary from France. His life was embroiled with political intrigues, and his work was interrupted and redirected by nations at war, usurpers overthrowing the government, and rival peoples failing to maintain peace long enough for the gospel to be preached. Still, Coillat demonstrated strength of will and character and single-mindedness as he did the job God sent him to do. On this date, in 1868, Francois Coillat baptized his first convert in Africa.
Disappointment can kill a man's dream, but perseverance can revive it. In February 1861, Francois Coillat arrived in Port Elizabeth, South Africa, to marry Christina McIntosh, but Christina wasn't there. Due to a postal error, Christina had not received Coillat's latest letter before she boarded her boat. Going by an earlier letter, she had traveled to meet him in Cape Town, 500 miles away. The couple had first met in 1859, and Coillat fell in love with her at first sight. Christina felt strongly that God had sent her this man, but Coillat chose not to act on his feeling. He was poor and filled with self-doubt, and he feared that life in South Africa would be too difficult for Christina. A few months later, his feelings for Christina had not gone away. He sensed the Lord calling him to write her with a bold request: marry him and become a missionary with him in South Africa. But Christina came from a wealthy family. She read books, listened to orchestras, and socialized with the rich and powerful. Her family and friends told her to reject Coillat's proposal. She looked at everything she had to lose and agreed with her counsel. She rejected his proposal. Coillat was devastated, but instead of allowing disappointment to cripple him, he focused on his mission in South Africa. He knew his highest calling was not to be married, but to share Jesus with those who had never heard of him. The Paris Missionary Society had sent him to the South African tribes of Basutoland, where the tribes worshiped every god but Jesus. Someone had to bring them the truth. 2 years passed, but Coillat's feelings for Christina only grew stronger. After much prayer, he was convinced God still wanted him to marry her. He summoned the courage to write her another letter. What Coillat didn't know was that during those 2 years, God had been speaking to Christina, challenging her to give up her comfortable life and be with Coillat in South Africa. Not long after she surrendered to God, Coillat's letter arrived. Christina wrote back, yes, she would marry him. He was overjoyed. Christina felt a deep peace from God, but the pain of saying goodbye to her family and friends, who she may never see again, was awful. She spent most of her long voyage to South Africa in tears. So in 1861, when Coillat discovered that his fiancée had arrived at the wrong destination alone, he set out at once to meet her. He jumped on a horse and rode as fast as he could to Cape Town. All day and night, he rode through the wilderness of South Africa, home to wild animals and hostile tribes who would not hesitate to kidnap or murder him. Coillat had no idea what Christina would say. They hadn't seen each other in 2 years. Her first words to him were, I have come to do the work of God with you, whatever it may be. Deeply moved by her faith, he thanked God for giving him this precious woman. They married on February 26th, 1861. Coillat never regretted waiting for Christina. Micah 7:7 says, But as for me, I will look to the Lord. I will wait for the God of my salvation. My God will hear me. Are you willing to wait patiently for what God has promised to give you? Disappointment can kill a man's dream, but perseverance can revive it.
Thank you for listening to today's story. Every day of the year, our hope is to inspire you with real-life stories of faithful men who have gone before us. Hebrews 12:1 says, "Therefore, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin that so easily ensnares us. Let us run with endurance the race that is set before us." Join us tomorrow for another story at 365christianmen.com.